Have you ever wondered how Brisbane Airport's runway system works? Or how the new parallel runway will operate? This video explains how aircraft are managed at one of Australia's busiest airports and what is being done to reduce the impact of aircraft noise on the community. Let's start by taking a closer look at Brisbane Airport itself. Brisbane Airport currently has two runways. The main runway is 3.6 kilometres long and carries most of the aircraft traffic in and out of Brisbane. The second is a shorter cross runway. It is 1.76 kilometres long and is used by smaller aircraft, generally those that operate regional services. The area between the end of a runway and the nearest residential house is referred to as a noise buffer zone, and Brisbane has the best noise buffer zone of any major airport in Australia. The nearest residential community along the centreline of the main runway is 6.7 kilometres away. It is safest for aircraft to land and depart into the wind. Here in Brisbane, our predominant wind patterns are north-south, so our main runway runs in a north-south alignment. When the prevailing wind is blowing from the north, an aircraft will approach over the city and take off over the bay. Alternatively, if the prevailing wind is coming from the south, aircraft will approach over the bay and take off over the city. During the night, between the hours of 10 p.m. and 6 a.m, when there is very little air traffic and little or no wind, aircraft can depart and arrive over Moreton Bay using the main runway. This is called nose-to-nose operations. On average, Brisbane Airport is currently achieving between 80% to 90% of operations in the nighttime hours over Moreton Bay using this operating system. To ensure the safe separation of aircraft, a maximum of 12 aircraft can be allowed to land or take off in 1 hour under this type of runway operation. This means that as air traffic increases, it will be increasingly difficult to operate over Moreton Bay during nighttime periods. Also note that during summer months, traffic between 5 a.m. and 6 a.m. increases significantly as a result of daylight savings in other states. Brisbane Airport is continuing to grow. Last year, it handled around 20 million passengers, and this number is expected to increase to approximately 45 million by 2029. To meet this growth, Brisbane Airport is planning to build a new runway. The new parallel runway will be 3.3 kilometres long, 2 kilometres west, and as the name suggests, parallel to the existing main runway, but slightly further to the north to minimise noise for the surrounding communities. Much like the existing runway, the nearest community to the end of the new runway centreline will be around 6 kilometres away. A parallel runway system is recognised as the ideal design for a major 24-hour international airport, not only providing the most efficient operation of aircraft, but also allowing adequate space for future terminal facilities. During peak periods, the runway system will basically operate in the same way as it does now, but generally with aircraft from the north and west using the new runway, and aircraft from the south and east being allocated the existing runway. One of the major benefits of the new runway is that it provides the greater opportunity to prolong and enhance overbay operations between 10 p.m. and 6 a.m. Instead of a maximum of 12 flights per hour on a single runway, two runways will be able to accommodate a maximum of 55 flights per hour over the bay, weather and traffic permitting. Modelling has demonstrated that the parallel runway system will continue to achieve more than 80% of aircraft movements over the bay between 10 p.m. and 6 a.m. until the year 2035 and beyond. Depending on weather and traffic conditions, the parallel runway may even allow additional hours of overbay operations. Finally, Brisbane Airport has one of the world's youngest aircraft fleets, resulting in less noise, less fuel burn, and fewer emissions. And with world-leading computer-controlled navigation technologies being pioneered right here in Brisbane, all sectors of the industry are working hard to make sure aviation is sustainable. Brisbane Airport's new parallel runway is widely recognised as the best way to cater for growth at Brisbane Airport into the future. It is one of Southeast Queensland's most important infrastructure projects, and it is fully funded by Brisbane Airport Corporation. Not a cent of taxpayer money will go into this project that will cost around $1.2 billion. Detailed design is well underway, with construction expected to commence in early 2012. With a 7 to 8 year construction period, the first planes will be landing on the new runway in 2020. The new parallel runway will be great for Brisbane and great for Queensland.